Subscribe to our YouTube channel News DNN by clicking the bell icon. Don't forget to like, comment and share.
All right, welcome everybody. We are thrilled to have you here for the launch of our trailer for our film Guilty. This is a film that explores the various versions of truth that collide when a girl from a small town accuses the college heartthrob of assault. We've started our journey at Netflix Film just about 4 years ago, but it's been quite a ride. We've had films like The Irishman, Roma, Bird Box.
Hi, and good afternoon. This is special today for various reasons. Firstly, I have to say, and I have to make a special mention to our childhood when I say this, that we, contrary to the word that has now become famous in our industry, which is nepotism, that is not the reason why any of us are here on this platform. Shishti and her family have been very close friends of ours, and our fathers were really dear friends, our mothers are dear friends today, and it's wonderful that we can collaborate as friends and keep that professional and personal relationship going. That's always a rare and a blurred line to kind of be on. But I think Shishti and us at Dharma and Dharmatic have managed to do that. And this has been an effective collaboration for various reasons. Netflix, as you all know, is a tremendous platform, a global platform that really encourages and nurtures strong content. So for us to collaborate with them was really an honor at our end, and also a privilege to actually be able to tell the stories we really want to, with the abandon and the craft and creativity that we really want to bring to the table. This is, for all practical purposes and for all of you to know, our first collaboration. Dharmatic and Netflix come together. There's been a lot of conjecture about other shows and other films that people think are Dharmatic and to do with us. But this is the first collaboration that is the Dharmatic Netflix exclusive deal collaboration, and that will be at a screen near you in March. And we're very, very excited to tell the story of Guilty. Guilty has intrigue, Guilty has resonance, Guilty has relevance. And more than that, Guilty has a strong narrative and storytelling and some terrific performances. We're very excited to actually have a film that is led by a solid mainstream star, but also bring new talent to the table along with a very strong filmmaker. So I'm very excited actually to share the preview of the film with you and to call on the members of the cast and the filmmaker and of course writers who always form the soul of any narrative. I'd like to begin by calling the CEO of Dharma Productions and a major stakeholder and partner in Dharmatic, Apurva Mehta. I'd like to call the head of creative development, digital and film, Somen Mishra. I'd like to now invite on stage the director. I am very excited to say that I've had the great privilege of working with lots of women directors. We've always had strong collaborations, and Ruchi Narayan has been a super experience for us and has really told a strong narrative with a lot of expertise and nuance. Ruchi, welcome. And now I'd like to invite the writers. We have Kanika Dhillon. I hope she's here. Is she here? Atika Chauhan. Atika and Kanika. So it's quite interesting. Hi, Atika. It's quite interesting that it's such a strong female-led narrative, led by a mainstream female actor, directed by a woman, I mean, creatively nurtured by a strong woman, and all of us at Dharma are such strong feminists, including Somen, Apurva, and me, that we feel like proud to tell this story and want to continue telling stories led by women, created by women, nurtured by women. I'd like to now invite on stage the exceptional cast. I want to start by saying that we have two debuts in this film, two actor debuts, both strong, strong artists who actually have made their debut with us at Dharmatic and also Dharma. Both of them, solid talents, and we are very excited to do a body of work with them even in the future. They've lent their talent and their creativity to the narrative of Guilty, and we're very, very excited. So I'd like to invite on stage Gur Fateh Pirzada. And a friend of mine and someone who's been waiting to exhale for very many years and is now breathing life into Guilty, none other than Akansha Ranjan Kapoor. I will tell you a very sweet story about Akansha, but only later. I'd like to invite on stage a solid artist, an artist who's playing a very integral part of Guilty, Tahir Shabir. Tahir has worked with us in the company at Dharma in the capacity of an assistant, actually, way back in 2011, and now marks a solid presence in our film, Guilty. And now, I'd like to invite someone who I consider my own, who I consider like was always a part of the company, even though she didn't make her debut with us, but I just feel like she did. I've just taken charge of her in my own way, in my own head, emotionally, with love in my heart. I want to invite an actor who has truly proved her strength time and again and keeps surprising people with her choices and has had the most wonderful last year with two mega blockbusters. Please welcome the gorgeous and the supremely talented Kiara Advani. All right. I think I have introduced practically everybody that was standing in the aisles. This is the team of Guilty, ladies and gentlemen, and we are guilty of only making a solid film. We hope you enjoy it when it's out at a screen near you. Right now, we're very happy to pose for you. As you know, that's what I do for a living. And after that, we will be showing you the very first look of Guilty.
It's a big family, ladies and gentlemen. This is your opportunity. This is your moment. Please go ahead and click all the pictures that you want. Two gentlemen, you don't look like a lawyer right now, clearly. All right. So I want to start by inviting the two ladies. You're going to get Kiara Advani and Akansha Ranjan Kapoor. Akansha, hi. And of course, the two gentlemen, Gur Fateh and Tahir. Gur Fateh Pirzada and Tahir Shabir. And please, you can sit now. Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, I know you have a lot of questions. So, who do we start with? There. Seema ji, correct? Mic's going to her. Can we put her mic on, please?
This is Seema, right, for first post. I just want to know, like, how relevant is this story in today's times, like, whatever is happening around us? And how was the experience working with Dharmatics for the first time?
Okay, hi everybody. Well, it was an amazing experience to make this film, and you know, when I first spoke to Karan about it and he said Netflix, I was super excited because I'm an avid Netflix watcher. It was like I was just super excited because it's not just Netflix and Dharmatic. I was Dharmatic's production number one. So I was like, yay.
One for the history books.
Yeah, really. I was like, oh my God. So it was a great experience. And, you know, working with, of course, Karan and Apurva, Sumain, and talking to Srishti about the film and shaping it to what it's come out. We had the best time. I think, you know, we'd all agree on the shoot. You know, it's feeling a bit surreal now suddenly to see the trailer and it's all coming to fruition. And what was the other
question?
How
relevant is it in present times?
So I mean, of course, I think it's all the more relevant today. It's always been a relevant issue. But these days, there's a lot of talk about it and there's a lot of awareness about it. So just about any kind of assault and, you know, who do you believe? And what interested me most in telling the story was that at the end of the day, when you read an article or you read a tweet or anything, there are opinions and a lot of things are academic. But the point is, in life, it is about human beings. And everybody is coming from a place, everyone has their own agenda. So when an issue like this happens, there are different reasons to believe and not believe. So how do you really know? And I think that is a question which bothers and plagues all of us. And how do you deal with it? How do you cope with it, whichever side you're on? Because everyone has a point of view, and everyone's point of view in some ways is relevant. So that is what was exciting to me. It was a human story about human complexities. And of course, something happens like that, and it does change everyone's life that night.
Firstly, hi everyone, and welcome to our trailer launch. I can see everyone's family, so like she said, it is finally all coming together. Well, for me, I think the game changer was Lust Stories. And that's why when Karan says that, although we didn't launch her in the films, but the film that made all of you take notice of me was a 30-minute short film in Lust Stories. So, for me, Netflix, any platform that is giving any artist an opportunity to showcase their talent is a huge opportunity. And Netflix has been that game changer for me. Coming to Guilty, I still remember I was in the car with Karan and he told me, I've just heard a narration. It's a very, very strong role. And it's the most thrilling script that I've heard. And I want you to hear this story. It's on Netflix. And he thought that I may have an apprehension in my mind because I had just signed on, you know, films like Kabir Singh, Good News, a couple of films under his banner, Dharma. But in my head, I was like, it doesn't matter the platform. What matters is how important the content is and how good the content is. And when you talk about Netflix, it's a platform that reaches 190 countries. It's much wider for any artist to reach out to an audience that, you know, I believe like 167 million. I was just reading all the stats. I wanted to sound smart. But I mean, that's insane. You don't, for an actor to reach out to so many people, that's what you want. That's why are we making films? We want to reach as many consumers as we can. So fortunately, the script that came to me was Guilty. It's Dharmatic's very first. And I feel somewhere Lust Stories was also a big game changer when it went on the OTT platform. So yeah, I mean, it's all right there. There was never a second thought. There was never a, should I do this, should I not? It just all seemed like a perfect opportunity.
Hi.
We'll continue to do those, but this is something very special, which when you know you're doing something especially for a platform, I think you can really give it your creative best. And I think that not just goes for being a director or a writer or actors, or you know, you can really do it the way you think it needs to be done.
Thank you.
How happy are you with the recent Filmfare Awards?
I'm so sorry. I was so busy celebrating a wedding in my family that I didn't know. I'm just hearing everything now. But Kabir Singh won Best Album, so I'm very happy. I'm not on the jury. What can I say? I don't know.
Sir, you're not getting the answers you want, aren't you?
Okay. So, I mean, I've been directing for a while. So I've also, I think, there is a difference when you're a woman and you are heading something. So, you know, one forms a way to deal with those things. There is a story behind.
Can I cut
guilty.
Her there? I asked, when I heard the narration, I asked Ruchi, have you had a similar incident or is this why you wrote this story? Like, what was the reason? Is this your story? Do you know? Where does this come from?
Okay, so basically, I did write, I mean, the seed of the idea and everything, which I then wrote with Kanika Dhillon and then Atika Chauhan, she wrote the dialogues. So, I mean, we were discussing the issues that women face on a normal day-to-day basis. And when you're writing a story, then, you know, you try and develop it into a dramatic exposition of that. So, I mean, it is different. It is different for a woman and it's different for a man, which you learn by observation. But at the end of the day, when you really want to do something, as you would know as well, we all find our own ways to do it. So,
isn't yeah. that sad that we have to find ways to achieve something which men just get it because male entitlement?
See, like, again, I just want to say the film, that was the seed. But I was very aware that there's also always going to be another side. There's another side about how men feel. Like if you talk to men, they also sometimes feel that women get an easy pass. We would be like, excuse me, that doesn't happen. So there's always two sides to an argument, which is actually what I wanted to capture in this film. But the seed was definitely feeling as a woman that, you know, we were trying to cast a film. And a lot of the male stars said no. And I was so angry and I was talking to Karan. And Karan told me, he's like, you know, there's really no reason for them to say no to you because this film is really good, the script is really good, and, you know, you've got a body of work, so they should be saying yes. But I have a feeling it could be because they're not comfortable working with a woman filmmaker. And I'm like, well, I love this film, but I'm not going to have a sex change for it. So I think the anger of that did fuel me wanting to make this film. And that really was the core basis. And then, of course, when you're writing a film, then you want to be fair to all the characters and give each person in your film dignity. And a story and a motivation and a thought process. So I think we found a good balance, a good human balance, but that was the core.
All right. So
I mean, we didn't want to get into any particular group. Technically, we've kept her as a Bengali, but as you can see, it's not really peculiar to any group or region or religion or anything like that. They are college kids, as you know, one sees today, and they're not defined by those things. They're defined by their characters. I mean, it's not really about that. Of course, because there's an alleged sexual assault, which forms the core of the film, I'm sure, you know, these questions could come up. But like I said, it is really about the different angles of each person connected to this story, whether they are the ones accusing, they are the accused, they are the investigators, or they're the affected party. So
the story is an incident of what happened one night, and like Ruchi said, it's that. And yet the film is actually very, very layered. Like, if you ask, I think any of us, what is a premise of guilty? I think we'll all... I will wait from it because there's so much, but I don't know how much since it's a thriller. Yeah. And it's also very layered with every character. So yesterday I called Karan and I said, what do I say? And he said something which I wrote down so I remember, which I really want to say because I think it aptly describes our film. So basically, consent is a victim of perception. I mugged it up.
Ooh.
He was like,
that's
hung it up.
A brilliant line.
No, but it's true, because what may be consensual to some may not be to others, and how each of us looks at it and takes it. Mm-hmm. So maybe the what you're saying, it may come up. That's why I think guilty is very thought-provoking. And you tell me when you see the film, when it releases.
Firstly, I'll just put this out there. I'm very nervous. This is my first ever everything. Apart from that, I think guilty is important for all of us. It's the most relevant film that I read when it was offered to me. And when I auditioned for it, I was like, this is something that is my dream. Like, I would love to be in a film, and especially be it the first one. First of everything, Thermatic as well, Karan sir, Apoorva. And also, I think when you guys watch the film, everyone's going to have a different perception of it and is going to take home something completely different from the other person. Even in a family of four, everyone might understand, have a different meaning of it, and they might say that, you know, watch guilty because of this, but the other person's like, you, but I got this from that. So, you guys watch it. Hopefully, you'll have a lot of good things to say about everyone and the film. I think I'm very proud of what my sister's done till now. She's really been an inspiration in life for the person that I am. Apart from that, my inspiration was someone completely different. I think when I started getting, started feeling that I want to be an actor, I watched a lot of films. I am happy to be a part of one of my idols' films, which is Ranbir Kapoor. I'm working in Brahmastra, and I love Ayan Mukherjee's earlier work, Wake Up Sid, Ye Jawani Ye Diwani. So I think Secret works in crazy ways, and that's what happened. They both were my inspiration, and that's because that's the reason why I'm here. And obviously, Karan sir.
If the story prime importance. So the creative freedom and the chut that you get in your mind, knowing that, you know, you're doing it for a platform and you can be as true to the story and whatever the story demands, is very inspiring. Because of course we all know that, you know, box office pressure.